Okay, so next step on this cut wheel for our nutcracker is to get a keyway put through it so we can get it on the spindle in the mill and actually get to cutting some of the grooves that we need to take out. So we got it in the press, we got the right keyway size and spacer, and we got it set up high enough so it'll drop through, and we'll just press this through a few times.
Okay.
This one. Well, wouldn't you know it, it looks like we're going to build another tool to get this cut wheel made. So right now I'm working on building a center that'll go into the back of the mill and hold the bar from flexing and moving as we're cutting the grooves in the cutter wheel. So let me get that set up and we'll get right to it. Alright, so continuing on the project from yesterday, we're building a center to put in the mill to go ahead and use that cut wheel that we made before, but in order to put the threads on the center for the nut to go on, now we have to mill out one of our tool holders to make sure to be able to fit this in there. So that's the next step we're working on today. We're going to get this in the mill and just take off a few thousandths enough to get this bar in the tool holder so we can continue to run the threads. Let me get that set up and run through the process. Okay, we got our piece in the mill. We got our mill bit in there. We'll take a measurement of the thickness we need to get in. Looks like 750 thousandths, 3/4 of an inch. Take a measurement of our
Yeah, just go.
Yeah, go and fit it in, huh?
Yeah, until it fits. But don't use that bit. Okay. That's a finished bit, and it'll just chew it up.
Right. Use one of those roughing bits?
Yeah. too. And in this case, before you touch, let's take it over here. Because if we don't have a DRO, that's where this comes into play. You can use this or not. I just butt it up. And when it's time, when you're getting to the end, and it can be anywhere in the last eighth of an inch or so. Then you, well, oh yeah, that's going to be a problem. Then you kick it out of gear and pull back at the same time.
Okay.
All right, so give it a shot.
Hey guys, Jason back out here in the shop, continuing working on the cutter that we got going for the Nutcracker project. So in the last segment, I had to build this tailstock support bar to hold our actual tooling bar secure as we ran through. We got it all made. We got the dividing head on, got it set up to where we're making 20 cutting edges on our tool here. When we were doing that, we did notice the thinness of the cutting edge, and Nick's a little concerned, you know, that how long that's gonna last. But if we have to make another one, and I'm sure we will later on down the road, we'll just go through and make a few less cutting edges and give us a little more working room here. So anyway, we got it set up. Everything's good to go. Let's get some coolant blasting on it, and we'll run a couple passes. All right. This time just to check the tightness. We put a lot of pressure cutting these, so looks good. Thank you. Okay guys, that's gonna do it for today. We got 14 different cuts in it. Come back tomorrow and get the other six, and we'll be ready to heat treat it.